Hello everyone, welcome back to a new ASMR video. My voice might sound a bit weird in this video because I'm actually quite sick, but I mean I figured that would prevent me from speaking too loud, so I guess that's an advantage. More videos. But again, like I do tend to have in a lot of my videos, I have a cup of tea off to the side that I will be sipping from so my voice doesn't get too raspy. And as you can see, I have 4 iPods in front of me, and only this one actually is currently charged up and works properly. So after I kind of explain the other 3, I talk about them a bit, I will be kind of going through my music library, even though this one is not quite up to date, and kind of talking about my favorite albums and artists. And because there are quite a lot of different generations of iPods, I have a sticky note off to the side here, reminding me what iPod is what. So, the oldest one I have here is, I think you can scratched up. Sorry, my voice is getting weird. And it is quite old. This is actually not the first iPod I've owned. I actually got this from like a resale shop for quite a cheap price because I needed it for an art project. Which is complicated, I'm not really gonna explain that, but it is the 2nd generation of the iPod Nano, and it wasn't quite, I think it is, but it does look quite similar to the 1st generation as well. It's not charged, so it won't turn on, but honestly, it's not in too bad of condition. It works pretty well. It's pretty scratched up on the side, but it has 2 gigabytes on here, which is all you really need for this kind of iPod. It doesn't take pictures or anything like that, so it's only music. And I don't know, I don't really get rid of this or any of these for that matter, because I enjoy collecting old things like old cameras and just kind of electronics like that. They just interest me. And to be quite honest, these are more interesting than like the iPod touches we have currently, and I do have one of those, but I decided not to share. Not doesn't really fit in because I like the button sounds on these. This one's just a tad bit thicker, but honestly, for the time period, I think it's pretty good. So the next one is actually the first iPod I ever owned. It is the iPod Nano 6th generation. These are actually pretty popular, if I can recall. And it doesn't turn on because this button here, which turns it on, I'm not exactly sure how it broke, but it's loose, so if you press it down, nothing really happens. You're just pressing down the button itself. It's not like connected. But if you plug it in, it still works, but you just can't turn it on. Like, you can hear those buttons make that sound, and then this is nothing. But I think it's pretty cool. I would still use it if it worked, and I have, like, stickers on the back here from when I used it. I used this when I was, like, in middle school. Our stickers on the back here, and let's see, there are stickers on the back here. I'm actually not sure how much storage is on here. I can't imagine that much, maybe 4. I had like 400 you imagine. There has to be a lot. But, I don't know. These were pretty cool. The iPod Nano now, that came right after this, is basically the screen except bigger, and I think they're pretty cool, and would have definitely loved to have one of those. For saying this is my first iPod, you can tell I didn't have them much growing up. And I had like a little slap watch that you could pop it in. Probably look like such a dork, but I thought it was cool. It's almost like the Apple Watch, except not way stupider. So next, we have the iPod Shuffle. And this is the 4th generation. I'm pretty sure it's the most recent one they came up with. You know, this one I think got from a friend who didn't want it anymore, and I was like, sure, I'll take it. As you can tell, this has no screen, which is why it's called Shuffle, because basically, you just load up all your music onto here, and shuffle it. There's no playlists or anything like that. You can just click play, skip tracks, and then control the volume. But, I don't know, it's cute, and I like having it, like, when I travel on an airplane, because, again, it's super small, and it's easy, just put it in your pocket, doesn't mess with Wi-Fi, internet connection, anything like that, and it's not too distracting, because sometimes I listen to music when I try to fall asleep, but then again, when I use my iPod Touch, I get distracted and want to go on YouTube, or Tumblr, or Instagram, and I end up not being able to sleep because of the distraction. But this is just shuffle and go. And you cannot, I think these three all don't have like outer speaker systems. Like you can't just play it and turn it up for everyone to hear. I'm guessing that was a bit newer of a concept. Again, I'm not an Apple product expert. But I know definitely if, like, this one, I'm guessing this one, because it's older, doesn't have it either. But you have to plug it into some sort of speaker, or get one of those, like, dual headphone splitters to share it with someone. So this next one is the iPod Nano 5th generation. And I actually got this one recently, because, I don't know, a lot of people think of an iPod, they like, or at least when I think of one, this is what kind of comes to mind, and I don't think it's in pretty good condition, and this one does have a camera, not the best quality, obviously. I actually think it may only take videos, not sure, I haven't played around with it that, setting. But and I thought this purple color was quite cool, because I don't even think they have this in the iPod Touch now. So that was interesting. And this one doesn't say how many gigabytes on it. I'm guessing 4. I think I maybe have over 400 songs on here as well. And again, none of them are too updated. But you can still go through. Look at, yeah, I think it only takes videos. And I like going to cover flow because I'm, oops, music. As you can tell, I'm not quite accustomed. I like going to cover flow. Scrolling through album covers, because I'm the kind of person who like buys music very much depending on what the album cover looks like, and the mixes. I also love the Genius mix feature, not on here in particular, but because I like how they give you suggestions related to the music you already have, and I like finding new artists that way. I won't play anything, or at least I'll try not to. Can't guarantee that I won't accidentally hit a button. Let's just make sure camera's focusing. Playlist? Do I even have Yeah. A couple. I might have mentioned this before, but I am a Nintendo fan. And I actually have quite a few Nintendo video game songs. sometimes when I just want to listen to like one particular artist, I'll just put a bunch in there, and so that's these random ones. You can just scroll through. I'm not used to it being like, how is this? A vertical detector? I know tech, not really. But I'm not used to it being sensitive to turning it, because these three don't do that, but this one does. And again, I'm not used to not being able to tap it. My nail studs here make nice little tapping sounds. I hope I'm not sniffling too much. I never get sick, so I'm not used to this. Just have some more tea. Okay. Quite a variety of music on here. A lot of people are really like surprised, but I go through phases where I like different genres of music. Let's see, right now I'll go to artists, and I like Sia a lot. I have more music from her on my just like the lyrics to her song. I'm very much the kind of person who likes almost satirical music. She's not satirical, but they're just interesting. She has a very interesting way of singing, and her music's very different. And I just have a huge respect for artists who can do that. Not that there's anything wrong with like the music you hear on the radio, but it all kind of tends to be about the same thing, and it's just kind of refreshing to get something different sometimes. So, let's see. Arctic Monkey is definitely a favorite. Fall Out Boy. George Ezra is actually a choice that a lot of people are surprised. I have a lot more than that. I have his entire album on my own. iPod Touch, but I find his music so relaxing, and I think Budapest is the one that's quite popular on the radio, but I listen to that album. I'm not sure what it's called, but Budapest is on the album. It might be, oh wait, it's right here, Wanted on Voyage, right there. I listened to that album before bed. Definitely a recommendation. Marina and the Diamonds, love. I have loved her for a long time, actually. Molly Martinez, again. She's actually a fan of Marina, so that kind of explains why I like her. I do actually have old Miley Cyrus songs on here. These are from her breakout album, which, that was a while ago. Some old Selena Gomez songs. 21 Pilots, VeggieTales. That's on there because some of my younger cousins, I suppose, when I babysit them, I play that. And people find that on my iPod, and I get a lot of questions. But yeah, this is the one I kind of take around with me. Again, this is definitely the shuffle. It's my favorite for traveling, but I don't know. Babysitting or stuff like that, which I do a lot for the younger members of my family, I'll take this along with me. And this one does have, like a little audio thing, speaker, I suppose, built into it, so you can play music from the device without looking at it anywhere. So, I still am getting used to how this works. Oh no, I wanted to turn it off. Now it's locked. There we go. Straighten that out. So, I'm sorry I'm sick, but just kind of wanted to do a bit of a ramble on my iPods. And I like to have these out sometimes because a lot of people find it interesting as well. And you can learn a lot about people by the music they listen to. But never judge people on what they listen to. That's something. Oops. I have a loose board right now that I'm filming on. And it moves. But one of my biggest pet peeves is when people judge others based on music preferences. And it's like, just let people be happy. Sorry for preaching about that, but thank you for watching this ASMR video, and I will see you all next time.